Nancy Harkness Love, 1914 to 1976. Nancy Harkness was born on February 14, 1914, in Houghton, Michigan. She developed an intense interest in aviation at an early age. 16 years old in 1930, she took her first flight and earned her pilot's license within a month. Later, she would carry this love of flying with her to Vassar College in Poughkeepsie, New York, where it was said she was restless and adventurous. She earned extra money by renting a plane and taking fellow students for rides. One time, she flew low over campus, almost touching the treetops, and someone turned in her plane's tail numbers. University officials were not amused. She was suspended from school for 2 weeks and forbidden to fly for the rest of the semester. Leaving her college studies, Nancy continued to pursue her career in flying. She was a charter member of the 99s, a female pilots organization founded by Amelia Earhart. In 1935, she was one of several women hired by the Bureau of Air Commerce to work on its Air Marketing Program, a Works Project Administration program to mark water towers, barn roofs, and the like, with city names and compass headings as aids to air navigation. By 1936, Nancy and her husband Robert Love were running their own business, Intercity Aviation, out of Boston Airport. In 1937 and 1938, she flew as a test pilot for Gwin Air Car Company, performing safety tests on various aircraft modifications, including the new tricycle landing gear that would be adopted on large aircraft. She was one of several Massachusetts women who ferried light planes to the Canadian border. It was during these ferry flights that she made her first contacts with the Army Air Corps' Air Ferrying Command. In 1942, after the outbreak of World War II, Nancy Love accompanied her husband to Washington, D.C., where he was to serve active duty. She soon landed a civilian post with the Air Transport Command, ATC, Ferrying Division Operation Office in Baltimore, Maryland. She continued to add to her 1,200-plus flying hours by piloting her own airplane on her daily commute from the couple's home in Washington. Even prior to her move to Washington, she had recognized the potential for women ferrying pilots. She succeeded in convincing the head of the ferrying division's domestic wing, then Colonel William H. Tunner, that using experienced women pilots to supplement the existing pilot force was a good idea. She envisioned the use of a small number of exceptionally well-qualified women pilots who would need only a minimum of training to transition to military aircraft. Some 28 candidates qualified, holding commercial pilot rating, but they were in short supply. With Colonel Tunner's support, the Women's Auxiliary Ferrying Squadron, WAFS, was established in September 1942 and began operations at Newcastle Army Airfield, Wilmington, Delaware, under ATC's 2nd Ferrying Group. With only 4 to 6 weeks of transitional training to acquaint them with military procedure, they performed ferry duty for the Air Transport Command. In 1943, the WAFS and the Women's Flying Training Detachment, WFTD, merged and became a single entity known as the Women Air Force Service Pilots, WASP, with Nancy Love serving as executive director on the ATC Ferrying Division staff, reporting to Jacqueline Cochran, Director of Women Pilots, AAF. Nancy was a hands-on manager and often delivered aircraft herself. Her duties included administration of 6 WASP ferrying squadrons and planning operational and training procedures. Charged with transporting military aircraft between factories, modification centers, depots, and operational units, this highly experienced group of aviatrixes freed male pilots for combat duty. Under Love's leadership, her squadrons amassed remarkable records of achievement. Nancy Love's personal contributions included some equally remarkable achievements. She was proficient in C-47s, A-36s, and 14 other types of military aircraft. She was the first woman in U.S. military history to fly the B-25, flying it coast to coast in record time, and, accompanied by Betty Gillies, was one of the first 2 women to check out in a B-17. At the end of the war, she and her husband had the unique distinction of being simultaneously awarded the Air Medal for their leadership and service in World War II. After the war, Nancy Love continued as an aviation industry leader and was a promoter for recognition of the women who had served as WASP as military veterans. They received their veteran status in 1977, shortly after her death on October 22, 1976.